Welcome to day 251 of the 300 movie challenge. Today we watched the highest grossing film of April 2015, which was Furious 7.
It's not Fast anymore.
No, apparently not.
We went from the non-Furious one to the non-Fast one.
Yeah.
God, the names of this series are so stupid. I still can't believe this made like $1.5 billion.
Yeah, I find it unbelievable as well.
And like,
hey, the stunts in this film.
Oh my god, they really like throwing cars like into the air, into the sky.
And then I think you mentioned at one point you were like, didn't they take out like a lot of the car porn in like Fast Five?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
We now know where it all went.
Yeah, well, to be fair, after, like, the first, I don't know, 20 minutes or so of this, it's, like, not as bad, but, yeah, the first 20 minutes is, like, really bad.
It goes back to some kind of plot.
Yeah.
Yeah, there is a plot.
Yeah, but it feels very, like, video gamey of, like, you know, you need this to do this, to do this, to do this, to do this, to beat the final boss. And it's like, I mean, I'm sure like every plot can be kind of summarized like that, but it feels especially basic here. So, and I don't know, I'm just, okay. Like, I don't really, I definitely don't like, don't dislike this as much as, like, the first one we saw, the fourth one.
Yeah,
that was pretty terrible.
That one was way so, like, over the top, like, in a bad way over the top of, like, you know, we think we're so cool or whatever. but I think I like the other one, Fast Five, a little bit more just because it wasn't as annoying. Because this one has just some, like, especially the, I don't know anyone's names. The two,
the woman?
Well, no, more like the two black guys. Like, I remember in Fast Five, they were, like, okay, but here I find, like, them, like, really obnoxious. And then, yeah, I feel like the story of this, again, it just, like, happens, and you're just like, okay. And, like, sure, some of the stunts are kind of, like, neat to see, although, again, it's, like, completely fucking ridiculous. Like,
especially the scene with them coming out of the airplane.
Okay, yeah, that, and again, I highly doubt, like, those dinky little parachutes would have done anything. And then, also, like, near the end, when apparently, like, the hacker lady, like, somehow swaps cars while they're just, like, quickly spinning around each other, and I'm like, how the fuck does that work? Literally at all. So,
yeah, I don't remember what her name is either.
She was Ramsey for some reason, but yeah, so that was like, okay, this dumb. And also the editing and also like the camera work was like kind of annoying. It wasn't like it wasn't like Taken 3 that was like worse, but it wasn't good.
I don't think anything can be Taken
3. No, it was really bad. Yeah, this was, like, I noticed there was a lot of, like, shots where, like, the camera, like, rotated with, like, whatever it's focusing on. Which, I don't know. Like, I can see that being cool, but at least for this, I don't know, I just felt like it was, like, trying too hard, I don't know. But, yeah, I don't know, I just kind of feel this is, like, this is a standard, kind of generic, not very engaging action movie.
Yeah, I don't even remember much of it.
Yeah. Well, that's the other problem, is it's over 2 hours.
Yeah.
So,
and it doesn't have to be.
No, they could just, like, cut out, like, some entire scenes and it wouldn't really be a problem. So, yeah. The only thing I can really say is, like, I guess a positive that, like, I didn't expect, really, was,
the ending?
Yeah, well, it was that, but also, like, in addition to the fact that, like, Okay, going into this, I didn't remember if Paul Walker died for this one or the next one. And so when, but while watching this, it's how they were portraying him in the movie. I was like, oh, okay. They're totally playing this up as, like, you know, with him. And, like, so I thought, of course, like, okay, they're going to make it so that, like, he's going to die. Like, his character's going to die. Because to me, that seemed like totally what they were going for with, like, you know, how he's, like, saying goodbye to his, well, not, you know, the not really goodbye to, like, you know, the wife and whatever and that kind of stuff, and focusing on him with the kid. Yeah. So I'm like, okay, they're going to make some tragic death out of him or whatever, and that's going to be the end. But yeah, they didn't do that, and it was like, okay, that ending was actually kind of nice in terms of what they did. And then again, they didn't kill him off, which I feel like, again, kind of would have been, like, kind of the simple way to do it. And I mean, this isn't exactly complicated, but it feels a bit more, like, earned.
I think it feels way more earned, and I think it was a better approach.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Because it kind of makes it more of a he's living on kind of thing.
Yeah, it's just that their lives will be separate from now on.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, but besides that, yeah, I just kind of don't really care about anything.
Yeah, that's a good way to sum it up. Besides, like, the ending tribute, nothing else really matters.
Yeah, which is, again, it just surprises me that this made so much damn money. And again, I've heard so many times that, like, I mentioned this, like, when we were first starting to watch these, that, like, you know, it actually is, like, you know, it starts dumb, but the series actually gets better as it goes along, and it's like, you know, the first one was not good. The fifth one, I was like, okay, it's better. I wouldn't say it's good, so maybe, but then this one, I'm like, and again, this is, like, the most popular ones, and this is the second to last one, so I'm like, okay, this has to be, like, when it's good now, right? And
it's the standard.
Yeah, so
at best.
I guess maybe it was also really popular because of Paul Walker.
Yeah, as like a send-off kind of thing.
I guess, but I don't think that it alone is, you know, 1.5 billion popular.
1.5 billion, yeah.
Again, that's just the thing that really surprises me, that it's that insane. Because this is like 7th or 8th highest grossing film like ever. It's like ridiculous.
Like, I wouldn't have thought like a movie like this would be that high. You know? Yeah,
like, let me check. But, yeah, it's just kind of strange. It's 7th. Well, okay, Furious 7 is 7th. Alright, fair enough. It almost beat Avengers. It's only 2 million away.
Oh, that's awkward.
Yeah, that's just strange. I don't know, it's just the fact that this is so insanely popular. And again, it's like, the reviews for it, like, are pretty good, actually. So, again, it's just, I don't know, I just find it so strange that, like, this is the one that this did so well. Because everything else, like, well, I guess not everything else, but, like, the other stuff that's does appropriately well, for the most part, makes a decent amount of sense. I guess, well, if anything, the ones that are actually the most surprising are probably the top two, Titanic and Avatar, but, because they're not really related to any, like, franchise or anything, but, yeah.
And, I mean, one of those we watched in, like, near the very beginning and everything, too.
Yeah.
Well, of the sense. That was all the way back in 1997, and it's still in second place.
Yeah, that's kind of crazy. Because I think if you, because again, because of, like, inflation and money and stuff, like, you know, more recent ones are always at the top. But, like, yeah, wow. Okay, in terms of the top, this list thing is the top 50.
Yeah.
I think, yeah. So in terms of the top 50, there's only 4 films released before 2000.
Oof.
Wow.
Which is Jurassic Park, Lion King, Titanic, and Phantom Menace. but even then, there's only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10 films released before 2010 on this list.
Wow.
Which is Harry Potter, Philosopher's Sorcerer's Stone, Two Towers, Finding Nemo, Return of the King, Dead Man's Chest, At World's End, Order of the Phoenix, Dark Knight, Half-Blood Prince, and Avatar. So
like, everything else is
in everything. The past, yeah. So that's
8-9 years.
That's in total 14 films. So that means 36 out of 50. So 72. Basically, 3/4 of the films are in the last decade.
Oh, that's weird to think about.
So, yeah, I don't know. Whatever. But yeah, I'm trying to think of anything else to say about this and feel just kind of brain dead.
Yeah, me too.
Oh, okay. One thing.
I guess
another stupid scene. Well, hold on. Another stupid scene that I remember was near the end when the two guys are fighting and like they shoot the missile at them or whatever, and like I guess they're on like an overpass or something and it like cracks, and then fucking Vin Diesel like sumo stomps the ground and it causes it to collapse or something, and I'm like, what the fuck is this? It's just stupid. Yeah, but I don't know.
Just gonna say that I would take this film over the February movie any day, though.
Yeah, that's not hard to do. I'd take fucking Taken 3 over that. Which is sad that I think this is better than Taken 3, but it is. It's not, like, way better, but it's also not, like, equal. It's noticeably somewhat better.
Yes.
But, yeah, so is there anything else to say? I feel bad. I feel like we should talk more about this because, you know, people like it. It made a shitload of money and it's really famous or whatever, but I just kind of feel so.
It could just be because we're not invested in the storyline.
Yeah.
Yeah, because we don't know a lot of what happened in, like, the earlier films and stuff.
Yeah, because it definitely seems like that this is apparently building off of the sixth one. I know I saw in theaters. Don't remember it at all. I remember something about a plane, and which was not this, because I'm pretty sure it was something that was, like, in at night. And then I also remember the whole thing where he jumps over, like, from one lane of a bridge to the other, jumps out of a car and grabs someone and lands to the other side. And I remember that because I'm like, it's so stupid.
Not possible.
Yeah, okay. Like, it's so stupid, but anyway. I don't remember anything else about it. Apparently, I guess the Vin Diesel's, like, wife is, like, alive somehow and back, however that works. I don't remember. So, whatever. I don't care about the story.
Continuity does exist, but it's you know, don't really know it very well, and I personally don't care to know the canon that much.
Yep, don't care about characters, don't care about the story. Some of the, like, things that happen are kind of neat, but if you really don't care, and especially since the movie's over 2 hours, it's just kind of makes you go, so... I guess if you can get into this stuff, then fine, it's not, you know, totally terrible and horrible and whatever, so, but, you know, for the super macho man franchise, this ultra masculine white male speaking to you, rawr, beefcake, don't laugh at me.
Rawr.
I just don't get it. I don't get why this is so popular, so... You failed. I failed the demographic test, I guess, but whatever.
We weren't even part of the demographic test.
Yeah, so you were for 50 Shades of Grey.
Oh god, no!
So I guess I win in that regard.
Hey, that's not fair.
No. I mean...
Well, technically it wasn't directed... We weren't part of that
that's
demographic
fair.
Either.
That's
fair. We're not...
We're not middle-aged housewives.
Yeah, but, I mean, general rule, I'll take a, like, lame who cares action movie over a lame who cares, like, romance movie, like, any day, so... I mean, 50 Shades is worse than that, but you get the idea.
Curse all of you who gave that money.
Just be glad 50 Shades didn't make as much money as this did.
Oh my god, thank god. It's probably because it was banned in a lot of countries.
Thank fuck.
Well, I guess, is that it for this?
Yeah, next movie, we return to a different franchise that made a shit ton of money.
Yeah, which actually made less than this movie, which, surprisingly. But, whatever.
I am kind of happy about that, though.
Yeah, I've heard mixed things about the next one, so...
You'll see.
Yeah, I will. But, yeah, and then... There's actually, now that I think about it, there's a lot of, like, really big 2015 movies. Because there's... Again, there's the next thing that we're about to watch, which was big. There's something that we're watching right after that, which was also big. And then there's a thing at the end of the year, which is huge. So, because actually, yeah, how many 2015 movies are on this list? Is it just those? No, there's another one, which is...
Oh, that one!
Oh, fuck, okay.
Oh, I thought that was the one that's next. Which one's the one that's next?
Well, this is next. Oh. This is next, and then this, and then this.
Never mind, I revoke my previous
basically statement. We are seeing four films in a row that all made over $1 billion.
Starting with this one,
yeah. Yeah.
Well, we're gonna die again later this year, so yeah. Look forward to that.
Yeah. Ugh. I think we got spoiled by 2014 being like pretty damn good.
Yeah.
How unfortunate.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I guess goodbye for now.
Bye.